all these diffusive processes in two parts, and then we'll study them separately. So these are the two parts we are going to divide them. The first is the spread of a disease on the left hand side as you see it, and the other is the spread of idea, information, it can be a behavior, anything goes on the right side. Do you think that a disease spreads exactly the same way as an information spread? So all this while scientists and researchers, they are trying to come up with models to see how diseases and information spread. Arushi says no. Can you give me a reason? Why do you think diseases do not spread the same way as ideas do? Very good, because we don't have a choice. We'll talk more about it. So for a long time, researchers, they have actually seen a lot of similarity in both of these phenomena. So they say that whatever model you make for a disease, you can actually apply it to model the spread of an idea as well. But lately, there has been a lot of research in this direction that they are not the same, and there is a whole lot of difference between them. If you talk about a disease, as Arushi said, it's more of a physiological phenomenon. It is related to your body. If you talk about an idea which is spreading, it's more on a sociological or psychological side, which talks more of your mind. Let's take this example. So all of us know that in this COVID situation, we have this virus which is spreading very fast. Let's say there are two things I'm considering their spread. So one is the disease, which is spreading very fast. And another is the information regarding the preventive measures for this disease. So that I'm writing it as preventive measures. Which do you think will spread faster? It is much obvious from today's scenario that the disease has spread much faster than the information which was required to curb it. Rather, if you look at the network on which corona is spreading, is way too sparse than the network over which this information is spreading. So already we have made this network for corona very sparse with the help of quarantining. So very less number of nodes are connected there. If we talk about information, we are densely connected with the help of all the online devices. Even then, this disease is spreading faster than the idea. In this particular example I took just now, the network which we are talking about are different for the spread of a disease and the spread of an information. Let me make these networks same and again ask you a question. I just named it as the big boss house analogy. You can consider it to be any game like a Splitsvilla or even Roadies, where certain people, they are isolated in a home. So let's say you are in this big boss house. You do not have any online devices to talk to your friends. If you want to talk to somebody, you'll have to go to them and talk to them. In this case, let's again say there are these two things spreading. One is a contagious disease, and second, let's say, is a personalized vaccination system, which is slightly expensive. Whenever a person comes to you, he can give you these two things. He or she can infect you with the disease, or he or she can give you the information regarding this new vaccination system. Again, which one do you think will impact you more? Is it the disease or is it the vaccination system? So one comes up with you, comes to you with the disease and tries to infect you. And in the another scenario, the same person comes to you and tries to offer you this information regarding this new vaccine. Which of it are you more likely to adopt? If you look at it, what will happen whenever a new person comes with a comes to us with an idea or let's say information, what happens is most of the time just one person saying it is not enough for us. I would want more of my friends to say that. Just one person hitting me with an idea or information or persuading me to buy something doesn't make much of a difference. The mind is different than the body. My mind wants more people to be there in that basket so that I can also adopt that information as shown in this figure. So if my friend walks to me with some idea and I see that none of my other friends is doing that, then I'll be hesitant to adopt that. On the other hand, if it was a disease, we cannot give an excuse like this, but no one else has this disease as of now, so I reject it. You do not have an option to reject a disease, but you have an option to reject an idea. Generally, we put it this way. In the case of a disease, just one interaction with an infected individual is enough to infect you. However, in the case of an idea, information, or behavior, you need multiple hits. So you want multiple people to transmit that to you in order for you to accept it. And we name it as social reinforcement. That is one part of it. If we are talking about spreading of certain things in a network, so what we just saw, it depends on the nature of thing. What is spreading? If it's an idea, it will spread in a different way. If it's a disease, it will spread in a different way. Idea requires reinforcement, disease doesn't.